Your Lacrosse View app comes with a built-in alerting system that allows you to set any number of custom alerts for all of your devices. In this video, we will show you how to set and delete alerts, manage their notification settings, show you where your in-app notifications are stored, and make sure you understand the difference between a device and alert notification. So, let's get started. There are two ways to set alerts in the Lacrosse View app. The first, as you might expect, is to go to the Alerts tab in the main menu. After pressing the tab, the Alerts page will come up, and either show a list of all the alerts you have already created, or a page like this, which will ask you if you'd like to set your first alert now. To do so, simply press the blue Add Alert or plus button at the bottom of the page. This will bring up a list of all your connected devices. Simply select the one you'd like to set an alert for, and pick the type of alert you wish to set. Doing so will open up the Alert Settings page, which will show you different options depending on which device you chose, and the type of alert you're setting. The first thing you'll want to do here is give the alert a name. Something that identifies the device's location and/or alert type could be helpful. Next, you'll want to adjust the alert settings to fit your needs, either by moving the sliders or by tapping inside the value boxes and entering your digits manually. After you have your alert value set, the last thing you may want to adjust is your alert notification settings. Do this by pressing the Show Notification Settings box on the bottom of the page. You'll be presented with two options. The default Once Daily setting will promptly send you a notification right when your alert conditions are met, and then not alert you again for 24 hours. The other Once Hourly option is pretty self-explanatory as well, in that instead of sending an alert once per day, it will send you one once per hour, should your readings continue to meet your alert conditions. Once you have all of your alert settings adjusted, make sure to press the Save button in the top right corner of the screen to create this alert and bring you back to your Alerts page within the app. Here you'll see the alert listed and have the ability to enable or disable it with the blue toggle switch to the right of its name. You can also use this page to edit any of your alerts by simply tapping their name. Just make sure to press the Save button again to save the changes. The final thing you can do while on this Alerts page is delete alerts. On iOS, like we are here, tap the red minus button to the left of the name, and then delete to the right. To delete an alert on an Android device, simply press and swipe the alert to the left. Exit this Alerts page by pressing Done in the upper right for iPhone users, or the back arrow button in the top left for those on an Android. Now that we're back on the main screen, let's show you the second, more convenient way to set alerts. First, you'll want to swipe left or right to find the device page you'd like to set an alert for. Once there, simply tap the current reading of the type of alert you wish to set. So for instance, if you're concerned about basement humidity, just touch this device's current humidity value to bring up the Humidity Alert Settings page for your basement sensor. Once here, you'll adjust the settings as needed and press Save. Doing so will bring you back to that device's main screen. You can always check to make sure your alerts are saved and activated by going to the Alerts tab in the main menu. Here, you should see the alert you just created. Now that we've shown you how and where to set, activate, edit, and delete alerts, let's cover what will happen when you receive an alert notification. Once an alert is triggered, you should receive a push notification on your mobile device, as well as an in-app alert that can be viewed in your Lacrosse View Notification Center. The Notification Center can be accessed by pressing its icon on the top information bar. When you receive notifications, its cloud will turn red and show a number for the amount of notifications you have. After pressing this icon, the Notification Center will present you with two tabs, one for alerts and one for devices. The Devices Notifications tab is where you'll receive shared device invites from friends or device low battery messages, but we will cover those in other videos. You'll actually want to check the Alerts Notification tab here, as it is where you'll find a list of the time-stamped weather alerts that have been triggered. Once viewed, you can delete these alerts by pressing the red X button on an iOS device, or by swiping left on an Android. Another, slightly more useful option though, would be to simply tap the alert to go directly to that device's page and view its current data. This will also clear it from your alert notifications. In doing so, if your device's readings are still within the alert range, you should notice that those numbers will display in red. They will continue this way until they move outside of the alert range. Or, of course, if you delete or disable the alert. So that's how to set alerts and receive their notifications within the Crosse View app. If you should have further questions or issues with any of the topics covered in this video, please just let us know in the YouTube comments section below. We are here to help you. In the meantime, don't forget to hit the subscribe button at the end of this video to receive all of our latest content and further video instruction. Thanks again for choosing La Crosse Technology.